Welcome to Hobbitron TV. My name is Nook, and in this video, we're going to be looking at the assembly and repair of the Sonic Camera Drone. If you're looking for the unboxing and review of the Sonic Camera Drone, you can click this video right here, and it'll take you right over to that video. Let's get started. So everything that I'm going to be going over today, you can find in the Sonic Camera Drone manual, which is at the bottom of the box when you open up your drone. First things first, I suggest go ahead and plugging in your battery so that while you're building your drone, you're ready to fly as soon as we're done. So to charge the battery, take your wall charger and look at the white connector. Pick up your rechargeable battery, and you'll also see that it has a white connector. Ignore the yellow one for now, we'll get there later. Now from here, all you have to do is hook up the wall charger and the battery. Inside the wall charger, you'll see three metal prongs. Inside the battery's hookup, you'll see three holes. Just line up the pins with the holes, plug it in, and you'll be ready to go. Whenever you plug in the wall charger, the LED light will appear red, and when it's done charging, it'll be green, and you'll be ready to fly. Now, with your battery charging and out of the way, let's take a look at the drone. The first thing we need to install are the rotor blade guards. These will be placed around your rotor blades, just in case you were to bump into anything while you're flying. To install the rotor blade guards, go ahead and flip your drone upside down. First, I'm going to grab a red guard, and these will be placed around your red blades. The color-coded blades help you keep track of the orientation of the drone as you're flying, just in case you were to lose what is the front and what is the back. The red is your front side, and these will help you keep track of that. So to attach these, line up the screw hole on the rotor blade guard with the screw hole on the bottom of the drone, and you'll see exactly where the rest of the screws need to go. One at the end, one on the peg. The other two arms of the guard will hook around to the top of the drone and connect just below the blades. There you go, the first step of building your Sonic Camera Drone is complete. Go ahead and repeat that with the other blade guards, and then we'll move on to the landing skids. Now you notice on the skids that there are three pegs, and on the bottom there are four sections with three holes. These line up very easily with those holes. Grab a screw and attach the landing skid like so. Again, repeat that with the remaining skids, and we'll move on to the drone's camera. So attaching the camera is extremely easy. On the top you'll see clips as well as the white rubbery stabilizers, and these clips will go right inside the clip holes on the bottom of the drone. Make sure the camera is facing forward or toward the red blades and guards. You just press the camera down, slide it forward, and it clips in. There you go. Now as for the wires on the camera, they made this very easy as well. Where the wires come out of the camera, you'll notice numbers, and on the drone itself, you'll also notice numbered hookups. The number one wire will slide into the number one slot, and the number two wire will slide into the number two slot. Just as we did with the battery and the charger, make sure to line up the pins with the holes of the connector. And the third wire is unnumbered, but you've only got one hole left, so go ahead and plug in the remaining wire to the remaining hookup. And there you go, the Sonic Camera Drone has earned its namesake by actually being a drone with an attached camera. Okay, now to record pictures and video, you're going to need to install the SD card that comes with the Sonic. On the back of the camera, you'll notice a slot just the size of an SD card, and magically, that's exactly where it goes. Make sure the numbers or the labeling of the SD card you're using are facing up according to the orientation of the drone. And the only thing left to do with the drone is to install the battery. On the bottom rear of the drone, you'll notice a battery cover with a screw in it. Go ahead and unscrew that, and you'll be able to unclip it and reveal the battery compartment. Inside the battery compartment, you'll find red and black wires going to a green connector. Go grab that battery we were charging, and you'll find a green connector on it as well. Both connectors have a square and circle hookup, which helps you easily identify where the hookup goes. Place the circle in the circle, square in the square, and your battery is connected. Then you'll be able to fit the battery inside of the drone, and there's enough space to place the wire and connection just above it. So clip on and reattach the battery cover and secure it with the screw. And now, your Sonic's ready to fly. But of course we need to put together the remote and the live view screen in order to enjoy everything about the Sonic. Here we go. So first, go ahead and grab your 2.4 gigahertz transmitter. On the back, you'll find a battery cover with a screw. Go ahead and remove the screw and the battery cover, and you're gonna need four AA's to power the transmitter. A diagram inside the battery compartment will show you how each AA needs to go. Once you have your batteries installed, go ahead and replace the battery cover and secure it with the screw. Now at this point, you're ready to fly. You can fly your drone around, you can tell it to record things, but you won't be able to see through the monitor. Now to use your live view monitor, go ahead and grab it out of the box, and underneath it you'll find a holder for it. Now how this holder works is one side extends, and you're just going to use that to clamp it around the live view monitor. It's very, very secure, very, very tight hold. On the back of the monitor holder, you'll find two circular clips that are going vertical, as well as two half circle clips that are going horizontal. The half circles will attach to the handle of the transmitter, and the circles will go around the antenna as you slide it down, and with a little bit of force, it clips into place. But don't forget your wire. The wire will connect just between the handle and the monitor on the top of the transmitter. There you go. Your transmitter and live view monitor are all set to go. So from here, when you get ready to fly, go ahead and hit the power on your Sonic first, then the power on your transmitter, and then you'll get your live feed through the monitor. Now, if you're flying around and one of your rotor blades ends up getting broken somehow, here's how you fix it. First, on the rod that is holding up the rotor blade, you'll find two screws on either side. Remove both of those screws, and the rotor blade will come right off. Now, the cone on top of these is connected through screws that are put through the bottom of the rotor blade. Remove those screws, and you'll be able to pop off the cone that sits on top of the rotor blades. Set aside the bad blade, grab one of the two replacement blades, and then simply do the process in reverse. Clip the cone to the blade, install your screws through the bottom of the blade to hold the cone in place, and then slide the cone and blade onto the metal rod, and screw in the two screws from the sides to secure it. And there you go. You're back in action. The only thing left to show you is how to get the pictures and videos from your drone onto your computer. In order to do that, you'll need to remove the SD card from the camera. By pressing it in, you'll hear a click sound and the card will follow your finger out. Take the USB card reader and slide the card into the reader. The reader then can be placed into any open USB port on your computer, and you'll be able to access the files through any file browser that you choose. And there you have it, the full assembly and repair process for the Sonic Camera Drone and the Live View Monitor. If you liked this video or found it helpful, please let me know down below with a like, and make sure to subscribe to stay tuned to Hobbitron TV. My name is Nook. I'll see you next time.